Hi, I'm Grayden with Paradise Energy Solutions. Today, I'm going to be explaining to you how to troubleshoot your SolarEdge inverter and to restore communications to your online portal. The first step to troubleshooting your inverter's communication is to pull out the My SolarEdge app. In this first screenshot, we are showing a system that is not communicating and producing properly. We can see at the top there is an error message with a caution symbol saying site is not producing. In this second screenshot, we are showing a system that is communicating and producing as it should. We can see there are no error messages, and in the middle of the screen, there is a representation of how much power is being produced at this current moment. This is what your screen should look like. The next step is to identify the inverter status LEDs. At the top, we have the red inverter error LED. If this light is on, then there is further troubleshooting needed. The next two lights are the green system production light and the blue system communicating light. If both of these lights are on, then your system is okay. If either of these lights are not on or if they are flashing, then there is further troubleshooting needed. If your inverter blue LED is off, we need to then identify what kind of communication type we have. There are two options. We could either have an Ethernet type or a cell kit type. For this inverter, we are using an Ethernet cable. This cable could either be black or blue. We need to then trace back the cable to the next communication device. After tracing back the Ethernet cable, we were then able to identify the next communication device is an Ethernet switch. This switch will include multiple ports for Ethernet cables to plug into, also a power cable for the Ethernet switch to get power from an outlet, and it will have activity lights either on the front or the side of the Ethernet switch. If you do not have this, please contact the Paradise Energy support team for further technical troubleshooting. Since we have an Ethernet switch, we will now unplug the Ethernet switch from the outlet and wait 2 to 3 minutes before plugging it back in. After waiting 2 to 3 minutes, we will now plug the Ethernet switch back into the outlet. After a few moments, we should start to see the activity LEDs on the Ethernet switch to turn on. These Ethernet lights are flashing, so now we know that our Ethernet switch is working. Let's proceed to the next step. The next step is to do a full inverter power cycle. We will first turn the toggle switch to the off position. The off position is represented by a zero on the inverter. We will now wait for the red LED to drain. Once the red LED is drained, we can turn this black toggle switch to the off position. Once the inverter is off, we will now need to shut off the AC power to the inverter. This will either be a combiner box like this, or it may even have a large disconnect handle that you can pull down. In this inverter, we have a breaker. We will flip this breaker to the off position. We will now wait 5 to 10 minutes for the inverter to drain its power. Now, after waiting 5 minutes, we will turn the inverter back on. We will first turn the inverter breaker on. This could also be the large disconnect handle. We will then head over to the inverter and turn the black switch to the on position. Then we will also turn the toggle switch to the middle position. After turning the inverter back on and waiting 5 minutes, the blinking LEDs should now turn to a solid green and a solid blue light. If this is the case, then congratulations, your inverter is now producing and communicating as it should. If either of these lights are off or flashing, or if the red LED is on, then please contact the Paradise Energy technical support team for further troubleshooting.